Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayewa last week directed the committee to investigate remarks by the minister that ridiculed the integrity of parliament. The committee, chaired by the vice chairperson Charles Onen, sat today to kick off their investigations with the complaints led by Bukoli Central MP Solomon Sirany and other MPs who seconded him. Minister Namganza, who was also expected, didn't show up, which annoyed the committee.
Actually, his client was in parliament when this matter was referred to the committee. Then the argument of not having been given enough time does not stand, because she actually knew she would appear in this committee.
Requested them to come with those evidences that pin Honorable Patsis Namuganza to ascertain whether the allegations they have made was correct or not.
The proceedings, however, hit a snag after the minister's lawyer, Norman Panda, informed the committee that they had filed a case in High Court in this matter, and hence the proceedings should not continue as Parliament cannot entertain a matter before court.
That she filed a judicial review case before the High Court Civil Division. It is miscellaneous cause 111 of 2022, Namuganza versus Princess versus Attorney General, challenging the acts of the ad hoc committee on Nakawa Naguru land. The matter is sub judice, and any act or hearing or action outside court is sub judice and may have influence on the outcomes of the matter.
The Osuku County MP Bosco Okirol agreed with the lawyer but noted that the issues before court could be different from those before parliament, and asked the lawyer to bring evidence that the committee is handling the same matter.
The mere allegation that is made in a letter as it has been done, but there has to be evidence adduced before this honorable committee for us to determine that the matter is sub judice or not.
The onus is upon him to convince this committee that actually what we are handling is what is in court. If it doesn't do us bad, we would give him time for the next meeting to bring evidence on matters of sub judice and be able to present that in a form of a report. If in our judgment is not, then we shall proceed.
The vice chairperson, Charles Onen, directed the lawyer to appear on Tuesday with the said evidence to enable the committee decide whether the matter before court was the same.
On Tuesday, I expect you to return to this committee at 10 a.m. with evidence alluding to your allegation that this committee cannot proceed because you have filed a case in the High Court.
Namganza is alleged to have made remarks that Parliament is powerless and unable to censor her. This was in her relation to her involvement in the Naguru Nakawa land allocations. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.